हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द थर्ड चैप्टर द टू स्टोरीज अबाउट फ्लाइंग एंड द सेकेंड पार्ट इज़ द ब्लैक एरोप्लेन। दिस पार्ट इज़ रिटन बाय फ्रेडरिक फोरसिथ। सो लेट वी स्टार्ट। इन दिस पार्ट फ्रेडरिक फोरसिथ डिस्क्राइब्स क्वाइट एन यूनिक बट मिस्टीरियस एक्सपीरियंस ड्यूरिंग हिज फ्लाइट From Paris to London. The moon was coming in the clear sky. The narrator was flying his old Dakota aeroplane over France back to England. He contacted Paris control for instructions. He was asked to turn 12 degrees west. He thought that he would be in time for English breakfast. Paris was 150 kilometers behind him. He saw the clouds in the sky. They were storm clouds. They looked like black mountains standing in front of him. He could not avoid by flying up and over them. He did not have enough petrol to fly around them north and south. He thought of going back to Paris. But he wanted to go home for breakfast. The narrator took the risk. He flew that old Dakota straight into the storm. Inside the clouds, everything was suddenly black. He could not see anything outside. The old aeroplane jumped and twisted in the air. He looked at the compass. It was dead. The other instruments were suddenly dead too. He tried the radio to contact Paris control. There was no answer. He did not know where he was. He was in a very hopeless situation. He was lost in the storm. Suddenly, he saw another aeroplane. The black aeroplane was flying next to him. He could see the pilot's face. He was glad to see another person. "Follow me," he said, waving his one hand. The narrator followed him like an obedient child. He followed the black aeroplane for half an hour. Now there was only enough fuel in the old Dakota's last tank to fly for 5 or 10 minutes. Then he started going down. He saw two straight lines of lights before him. It was a runway. "An airport," he cried in joy. He turned to look for his friend in the black aeroplane. But the sky was empty. He wanted to say thank you to his rescuer. After landing, he went to the control tower. He asked the lady there where he was. He also asked who the other pilot was. She looked at him strangely and then laughed. She replied that no other aeroplane was flying that night. She could only see his aeroplane on the radar. Who helped the narrator to arrive there safely without compass or a radio and without any more fuel in his tanks? It remained an unsolved mystery. Okay, students, so this was the summary of the chapter, The Black Aeroplane. Thank you.